The whole snake charmer thing, a lot of it is just sort of a sideshow to kind of get attention. And usually get money. People often give money. And it's kind of like someone playing the guitar outside the subway. You're hoping they come by and give them donations. The whole snake charmer thing, it's kind of a trick. They're actually kind of fooling everybody watching. Because snakes like cobras can't hear any of the sounds. They don't hear the music at all. No snake can. So what happens is, usually they're kept in baskets, kind of smack the side of the basket, the cobra pops his head up and sees what's going on. And his whole world's just been kind of shaking around. And if they get the flute, they're long and narrow, and then they get wide at the end. When they play it, they kind of bounce it around. So now there's this thing moving in front of your face like this, and the cobra's kind of following it to see what's going on, to make sure he doesn't get hit again. And as he follows it, it kind of looks like he's dancing to the music. And that's really all it is. The cobras aren't going to worship them. In fact, cobras don't really like anybody. They live on their own. They're solitary creatures. They don't have any friends. They don't have other cobra friends or any friends of any sort. So they're never really going to become friends of people or follow people around. And most of the snake charmers, they don't really do any nice things to the cobras, so they're definitely not worshipping the cobras either. There are places where cobras are venerated. In Bali, there's a ritual where they go find king cobras, and they make an offering, and they kind of sprinkle some white powder on the cobra, or rice on the cobra's foot, and then they'll often kind of kiss the top of the cobra's head, the side of his back, and walk away, or they'll kind of touch the cobra in the head. That's a sort of a traditional thing for the area. It's not really something that everybody does there, but they do that. Some places, they kind of venerate the cobra, because cobras are pretty useful creatures. They kill and eat rats and mice and other pests. They make sure that there's plenty of food, because they're getting rid of some of the vermin that cause problems. And it kind of works to make everybody's life better. You get rid of all the cobras, and you have an explosion of rodents, and then they start to eat all your food. They cause problems, they spread disease. So the cobras are pretty valuable, and a lot of people realize that. And living with cobras, you often realize that they don't really chase after you or attack you. They tend to pretty much leave people alone and go the other way.